Okay, we're playing the I Don't currently.
Love it.
When I'm talking to you, like, off radio, I've just turned off this thing, so we've got that.
And Daniel? Oh, sorry.
Tanjier?
Omar? Yeah, that's me.
And me, Jayne.
Hey, hello. Nice one. How's it going, everyone?
It's going.
We're still alive.
Still alive, still here. That's the ball of success. So what have people been up, getting up to, like, in their sort of downtime here?
Animal Crossing.
Oh, yes. Absolutely.
Why is that? Why?
Animal Crossing's a bit of a massive fad at the moment, isn't it? It's like...
Yeah. It's so good.
It's so good. Why is it only available on Nintendo Switch, though? Why?
That's because it's a Nintendo game.
I don't have Animal Crossing, but I recently got Stardew Valley, so I've been sinking a bunch of time into that as well.
Mm-hmm.
Fair. What else have we been getting up to as well? Like, what other things? Tell us things, guys. Tell us things.
Lots of binge watching.
Oh, like?
Yeah, lots of binge watching. What have we binged today? Or what have we been binging?
Fargo, because that have taken far too long to get onto that, and it's fantastic. This is a Fargo like plug now. It's on Netflix.
Nice. So Fargo, it's on Netflix. Is it the entire season's on Netflix, right? How long is it there for? Yeah. Like, is it? It's not going anytime soon because I need to.
I hope not. There's 10 episodes a season, and they're all. It's like each season is its own thing, so it's like anthological in that sense. But they're all tied to the town Fargo in Minnesota.
Would you say it's better than the Coen Brothers' original film?
Aspects of it are, but the heart and the warmth just is so genuine. It's so gorgeous in the film, but the show is absolutely a worthy successor and has just keep you hooked the whole way through. It's great.
Mm.
It's just part of the canon of Fargo. That's what it is.
Yeah.
Nice.
We're delighted to be joined as well by Jayne Flowers again. Woo!
You are Jayne.
How's it going?
Thank you for having me.
How have you been?
I've been good. I am in like dissertation countdown, so I only have three things to talk about. It's dissertation, work, or Animal Crossing at the moment.
Oh, excellent. Well, I mean, you'll get through it eventually.
The two pillars of self-isolation.
Pretty much.
Many, many pillars indeed and stuff. So you're going to be talking to us later on the show about... What was the film? Trolls World Tour.
Trolls World Tour.
Oh, like, my gosh. Bigger. It's back. It's bigger and better.
It's here. I'm so excited. It's finally here.
Yeah. And we got Dan as well. Hey, Dan.
You all right?
Yeah, good.
I was going to ask, so because we're live, we're not allowed to swear, sadly.
No, I mean, I've already marked this show as containing explicit content potentially, so you can if you want.
Explicit content? Really?
Wang.
So when you look it up on Spotify afterwards, it's going to say explicit. You know when like some songs have the word explicit in it. So
what do you think we're doing?
I don't know. I mean, it's a film show. You know, there's got to be
really
some profanity involved.
What can we do? Oh, yeah. It's just sound. We should do some weird ASMR stuff.
Ooh, a bit strange.
Dan, you're going for it. He's been in self-isolation so long.
Someone's been watching The Shining a bit too much, I think.
Come play with us, Louis.
So, this is literally a marvel of the technological world. We're currently Skyping between different people at the moment. We've got, like, I think six people in the chat? I think so. Five or six. Yarp. And we've also got the delightful Tom Rooney. Hello, Tom.
Hello!
Hi, Tom.
How's it going?
It's, I'm doing as well as I can, I think. I hope. Yeah, time will tell.
And what does that entail? What you been getting up to?
Not a lot of anything other than watching movies and walking my dog, because that she gives me an excuse to get my government-mandated exercise in.
Absolutely, absolutely. And we've also got Sam Midwood is joining us as well. I think so. Nice. But before that, we've got Tanjier Reid. Hey, Tanj! Woo!
Woo!
How's it going?
I'm all right, you know. I've actually managed to get some work done.
Hey, fantastic.
Through some miracle.
Brilliant. And so what kind of work have you been getting up to and stuff? Like, is that today? Is that just recently? Is that...
I've been working on setting up a vlog. It's not done yet, but I'll let you know when it is. But I've also been doing, like, uni work. I've got 20,000 words done in the last 3 weeks. Yay.
Nice. Very good.
Huge amount.
Hey.
A bit busy, isn't it?
I don't know. Can someone try and get Sam into the stream as well? Because I'm having a bit of difficulty. He should have added us. I don't know.
I don't know.
trying to get him added. It's not working. It's not working.
I don't want to be a pie.
I know. I think it's high time that we see Chicken Run.
Okay, if we want smoking film recommendations, Chicken Run is free on Amazon Prime.
Yes, exactly.
Without a doubt. It is.
if anyone listening hasn't seen it, do it.
Yeah, I was going to say, where have you been if you haven't seen Chicken Run?
Go on Prime and watch Chicken Run. Right.
Absolutely.
Chicken Run is fantastic. I mean, I think Chicken Run should be the recommendation of the week, don't you think?
Quite frankly,
I think you just inspired me. I'm going to watch it.
Fuck Parasite, Chicken Run, best movie of the 2000s.
God, I cannot believe you said fuck Parasite.
I love Parasite as well, but come on, it's
a dead film.
That is a bit mental.
Bless you.
That's all we're saying. Cool. So on today's show, we've got quite a lot going on. We have got tons of kind of chat to do, sort of film stuff. We've got sort of rumours and news we're talking about. How are we holding up in isolation? Let's do a sort of, we've done a bit of a round robin check of that. Still having trouble getting Sam to the stream, so can someone help us out? We've also, what have we been watching? What have we been watching? Should we do a bit of a round robin of that? Starting off with Tanjier.
Yeah, I finally watched Beetlejuice earlier today.
How did you find
it? It is a mad film.
Yeah.
No! Yeah.
It is mad. It is crazy.
It is very good.
It's like Tim Burton-esque. Like, it's Tim Burton, but then you just put Tim Burton on steroids and then just let him, like, savage.
Yeah.
In, like, a Midwestern town.
Is definitely like I enjoyed it. I didn't think I would enjoy that much.
Hey, and there's Sam Midwards.
We have a Sam.
You just joined us. Hello, how's it going?
Ooh, hi, Sam.
Good. I forgot it was what time it was and went for a run, so I am slightly out of breath and not confident.
That's better late than ever, eh?
Yep. So yeah, good though. I'm ready for some film chat.
Fantastic. We're just sort of doing a bit of a round robin introductions. What's tonight's? So Sam delightfully has been arranging our smoking film suggestions, which is all available on social media. So Sam, what is tonight's smoking film suggestion?
Well, it has been posted an hour later, but obviously think of it as daylight saving time. So we have shared Cameron Brown, a newest member of the Smoke Film Show, and his suggestion was called Altered States, which is a 1980 film, and it is directed by Ken Russell. So, controversial, but it sounds like it's really good though. So, it's got.
Do you want to tell us a bit about Altered States while you're tantalizing us?
It basically follows a psychopathologist, Eddie Jessup, as he becomes obsessed with delving deeper into his own consciousness and tries to discover that absolute essence may lie beneath. So contrasting to his own relationship with his wife, who he meets at a party one day, and the film consists of, as Cameron puts it, Spielbergian drama scenes, which feature compelling and realistic dialogue. So psychedelic sequences. So kind of sounds like
a barrel of laughs.
Yeah. Right now, so
if you combine David Lynch and Spielberg, is what you're saying?
Yeah, nice. Sprinkle a bit.
Was it Ken Russell?
Ken Russell, yeah. So consult Cameron, who will be on the show apparently next week.
Not to be confused with David Russell or Ken Loach. Just so you know,
Kurt Russell
or Anthony Russell. But, yeah.
True, exactly. Very, very true. Thank you very much for that smoking film suggestion.
No worries. Yeah, they've been good so far. So they've been good, good suggestions. So if anyone else who's outside Smoke Radio wants to suggest, then just can join in as well. Because so far, I have given way too many of my nerdy suggestions, and it's starting. My Disney love is starting to leak in. So we've got to stop that.
I think we've got to keep that coming.
No one's judging you for Disney love here.
No, it's good. Yeah, no, because it's going to be up. You know, just. Well, those are Pixar, obviously, but you know, the Jungle Book, the old one's the best. So there you go.
Of course, yeah, the old ones are the best. Exactly. I take it you've been binge watching massively on Disney Plus.
I have, yeah. I'm actually now on leave for my job. I'm basically being paid to do what I want, which is not too bad. So yes, yeah, so I've got the Disney Plus. I've watched the live action of Lady and the Tramp, which is on there, which didn't really get much kind of announcement, which was a shame. But it's actually pretty good.
Is it all right? Like, oh, okay.
Was it at least better than the live-action Lion King?
Yeah, they actually have. They can show emotions, actually, on the animals this time. So.
Live-action Lion King was just complete cack.
Yeah, no, I know. So, yeah, no, that was good. And then all the classics as well. So Mrs. Doubtfire was on there, you know. So got to top that
up. Oh, classic. You know. Rest in peace, Robin Williams.
Yeah. Every two. Obviously, so
yeah,
correct. Yeah. What's it I've been watching?
The Ooh. Silence is seething.
Have you been watching a lot of films?
Have you got
lots
one
of
Luke?
Weird ones?
You got one
what I'm watching? Oh, okay. I don't know.
I sense a deep repressed film in your mind.
No, I don't. Wouldn't say there's repressed films. I'd say I've been watching some films. I've been watching quite a lot of documentaries. Weirdly. I haven't watched anything like that's like super new and stuff. I'm kind of like trying to sort of like claw back into the classics a little bit and kind of look at sort of early stuff and things that I might have missed from my time at university. And you know, stuff on the reading list that I was just like, nah, I've seen it, or I'll get round to seeing it at some point, but I just chose not to because I was
never do.
I was so stubborn. Yeah, you never get through it.
Never do.
You never do. No, there is quite a lot.
Haven't
there.
Seen Breathless. Maybe one.
Oh, that's all right.
Which Breathless are we talking
There's
about?
There's only
the
one Breathless.
One true Froze. It's the only one.
I think it's Godard, but yeah.
It is Godard.
Jean-Luc Godard.
Controversial opinion. I hate that movie.
that is controversial. That is very controversial.
That would make John very happy.
Yeah, it would. It would, for sure. But no, what I'm watching, just a lot of like, just a lot of telly and stuff at the moment. Like, I'm trying to start Breaking Bad, which is all right. I know, I'm a bit late to the party. I know.
Better late than ever.
I know, better than ever.
Because there's a film out as well. You gotta watch the film.
Yeah, and also Better Call Saul, apparently, is a very good spin-off season. I've got a lot to go,
Louis.
I'm far ahead. I'm far behind. So yeah, someone else take over.
Where are you right now in the series?
I'm halfway through episode one because I got lazy. I literally, like, I've emphasized, I did just start watching it. Like,
okay.
I will tell you more about the plot and how I feel about it in due course. Someone else take over.
Okay. What else have you been doing?
Anyone?
Wait, who's going?
Fire away. I think first one comes serve. Yep.
Yeah, I'll do it. Today, something I've been meaning to watch for a long time, finally got around to. Once, directed by John Carney, who also directed Begin Again and Sing Street. And Sing Street is one of my favourite movies of all time. So I was very excited to finally watch Once. And it was everything I was expecting. I loved it. Like, it's really low-key, like, really quite... It's so, like, the cinematography and everything is quite rough around the edges, because I think he filmed it with, like, just a standard video camera, but it's, and the two leads are great with each other. Like, they've been performing professionally prior to being in the movie, and the songs that with a John Carney movie always comes like incredible music. And Falling Slowly from Once won an Oscar against three songs nominated from the Disney movie Enchanted.
Wow.
Yeah,
I didn't know that. Yeah, because Enchanted's got a lot of praise. So,
yeah. And speaking of Disney, well, technically Pixar, I'm trying to. There are three Pixar movies I haven't seen. One of them, which I finally, well, two now. One of them I finally got around to the other day. A Bug's Life, which
yes!
I'd never seen before
The original. The original Bugs Life.
Oh my god.
There's only one Bugs Life, Louis.
What do you mean there's no remake?
Well, there's some dodgy spin-offs I've seen on YouTube, but they're not official. Yeah, so bad.
Not even Jon Favreau can get real ants to emote.
I would love that. I would love that.
That's a gem. Bugs Life is a gem.
Yeah, it was a good.
Better than, what was it? Ants. Do you remember that one?
Oh, right, here's the thing. Which is better?
So weird. Obviously a Bug's Life, because it's like Seven Samurai, so like that wins by default. Anything that's ripping off Seven Samurai wins.
I felt so uncultured by watching a Bug's Life before Seven Samurai. I watched Seven Samurai for the first time, just like, this is like Bug's Life. Like, shit! And I know where this comes from.
Oh my gosh. Very uncultured indeed. Who else have a go?
Now I have to watch Seven Samurai and figure out if you're bollocks or not.
I'm not a bollock.
Genuinely. Seven Bugs is
take it from a film student. Take it from a film person.
Take it from a Kurosawa advocate. I'm like the
You love Kurosawa, don't you, Omar?
So much.
Basically the godfather of Hollywood. Like he caused all of like the classic like directors like to just bash their films from his style and his like now.
He was someone that everyone like the modern contemporaries like Tarantino and Lynch kind of drooled over, really, wasn't he?
Spielberg,
Spielberg especially. Yeah, nice. What else have we been watching? Tanj.
Well, I talked about Beetlejuice as well, and then 2001: A Space Odyssey, which is way too fucking long.
You shut your whore mouth.
Man,
well, actually, no.
The whole
Dawn of Man, like, remove that and boom,
need to be watching Cheers for Tea.
Tom, how could you say that? We saw it together in 70mm at the Prince Charles.
The Dawn of Man was the worst part of it.
How dare you?
Like, yeah, 70mm, the Stargate chef's kiss, but, like,
did you like the trippy sequence, Tanj, that was like all like crazy colours? That's my favourite bit. There's the Stargate sequence.
I liked it very much. It just took up too much of my time.
It's a big commitment. I mean, don't tell that to Kubrick's grave or there. You know, any.
That will might make him a little bit upset.
It might.
Just a bit.
But overall, just any other comments about the film?
Yeah, it's a brilliant film. There's another film I watched as well, but I want to talk about when we get to trailers.
Oh yeah,
because it's one of
exciting, nice. And who else has been seeing stuff and wants to say what they've been seeing?
Police Story. Oh, sorry, I've cut in again.
It's all right. Very very enthusiastic today, Omar.
Yes.
I quit. I can't do this anymore. No, I'm joking.
Omar tells you to fuck off.
Okay. Chaos on an absolute scene.
This is so chaotic.
I know.
I love it.
Yeah. Yes. You go. On.
Get out, Omar.
Chaos
okay.
Also a great film.
Yeah.
Whose turn is it now?
I'm really confused as the order's gone.
Ahead. Fucking talk.
Okay. I'll preach Police Story real quick. It's Jackie Chan. He chases a bus. There's a bit where they drive cars through a village. It's mad. It's fantastic.
That sounds insane.
Nothing but fun. And
I would like it hooked to my veins right now.
Do it. Just go watch it wherever you can. YouTube movies, Amazon Prime. I don't know where, but it's fantastic. Love it.
Good.
Hello.
Yeah, I was just gonna say we lost Jayne, and
I think Jayne's coming back. Yeah, she's joined. Woo! It's cool. I quite admire that. Like, people are gonna be hearing our like connection failures and successes and stuff like that, internet wise. It's like it reminds them of the self isolation world that we're currently living in. You know,
it makes it more relatable. You know, we're kind of down with the kids. You know.
That was not down with the kids, by any respect.
Hello, kids.
How do you do down below? Yeah, exactly.
If it's just voice, they'd think I'm 50. It's great.
If we were to like turn off our videos, who would sound the oldest? That's quite an interesting game, isn't it?
Okay, boomer.
Omar started it first.
Yeah.
So that's all I'll say.
It was the year of 1970.
Oh. Someone has just gotten old very quickly.
Sound like a
little I think that's quite a good game to play, actually. Like, who can do the best old person's voice in a round robin scenario? Is that a rubbish game?
We're really getting off the rails.
Yeah, I think we should stay. Let's stay back on our agenda. Well, there we go.
New films that we've seen.
Okay, so new films. So, has anyone
given a film where we talk about being old?
Go on.
Hmm?
Oh, what? I missed you there.
This isolation is just aging us all.
Oh yeah.
That's it. Just that's it.
Make sure you get your. Go on.
Can I make like a film suggestion?
And absolutely.
I want your opinion on all of this, guys. Are we like? Is there like a general liking towards David Fincher?
Ooh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Because there's a film that he made that people like kind of see as the black sheep of his films that I think like speaking of old age.
Benjamin is it Alien 3?
No.
No.
A Curious Case of Benjamin Button. I was kind of curious what people's thoughts on that because people don't like it.
Extra emphasis on the curious.
I always thought that was a really good film.
I haven't seen it.
It's, yeah, like I think it's good for Brad Pitt as well. Like considering the action films he's done, Troy and those kind of films. So good, kind of more deeper emotions from Brad Pitt because he did pretty well.
We like that. We like deeper Brad Pitt. It's good. but yeah, no, Brad Pitt, he's been maturing quite recently, isn't he, with new roles. Oh, yeah. Like, I thought there was some really profound moments in Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, even though I hated that film.
Yeah.
I also think, shout out to Brad Pitt in 12 Monkeys. He's really
absolutely
good at that.
Absolutely.
Brad Pitt, after reading.
That's someone I'm going to try and get on the show, is the editor of that
he's
film.
He's good in that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is it just me or like Brad Pitt and Chris Hemsworth? I really get them mixed up sometimes in like not exactly.
I think they look quite different. You mean looks wise or like acting style or what?
Looks wise, yeah.
Oh,
like
okay.
One's Australian.
I don't know.
Just me. It's fine.
I get Naomi Watts and Kirsten Dunst mixed up quite a lot. They're quite similar.
Yeah,
I think.
Naomi Watts and Nicole
Kidman. And Kate Blanchett.
There was an entire... The movie The Old Man and the Gun. Casey Affleck, I think, is in that movie. But I spent the entire movie thinking he was Charlie Day.
The entire movie.
Very interesting.
And
also,
the same day, the movie Colette. Who's the male lead in that movie?
Oh, dear.
I can't even
remember what that
Hang on, I'm looking it up now. Who was it?
I hope Tony
it was Dominic
Collette
West. I thought that entire movie. I thought he was Kenneth Branagh.
Oh my god!
I guess they're kind of similar.
I am not the sharpest tool in the shed.
No, clearly not.
Bruh.
There is so much shade.
Full on insulting now. I love it.
I mean, thank goodness I put explicit on the show description. Thank goodness.
They're quite different. I mean, they're all from England.
So who else has gotten actors mixed up before? Or people?
I can never remember Jude Law's face. As soon as he's off screen, I'm like, who is he again?
I can't remember his face.
It's a real thing. I cannot remember what he looks like or recall. I can vaguely picture his eyes, but that's about it.
Yeah, come to think of it, I'm trying to think of Jude Law right now, and I can't seem to picture him either.
He's like a weird...
Get on my level.
Hole. It's strange. Yeah.
He's like not quite Benedict Cumberbatch, but also not like Jake Gyllenhaal. He's like kind of somewhere in between. Yeah.
Maybe he's like stuck between universes. Like,
I think so.
You've got like Taron Egerton and Ansel Elgort, those kind of like...
Oh, that's confusing.
Like,
yeah.
Nothing alike.
They look super different.
No, but I get that. Like, they kind of... I have that kind of white young man look where they just kind of meld into one.
That Tom Holland, well, all that kind of, you know.
Yeah, they all look like they've literally just like been shipped out of Eton, you know, just like ready to go.
Well, yeah. Any film with like Tilda Swinton like in will have you double guessing like how many of the cast members she's playing at once, like so. She's just there to annoy people.
when Luke Evans first became massive, I always thought he was Orlando Bloom. And then they're both in The Hobbit, so I got even more confused.
I was going to say, he really does look like Orlando Bloom, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like, yeah.
Look where we're at.
This has been a very beautiful digression, actually. I have to say, this has been lovely.
It's still about film, so
it's absolutely still about film. I mean, like this is what the show's for, eh? Beautiful digressions.
I think they get stuck in like their roles, maybe, than like what they look like. Like I feel like DiCaprio and Orlando Bloom play very similar kind of characters sometimes.
I don't know. Oh, sometimes, but like
you could say that for any two actors in the industry.
I would say that. Yeah, I say that Johnny Depp in every film he's been in is pretty much the same one tone dimension performance.
Have you seen Edward Scissorhands?
Oh yeah, no, that's true. There's one film.
I've seen Fear and Loathing.
Louis,
sorry.
Oh, I haven't seen Fear and Loathing. I need to get on that.
It's pretty mad in that. I like that.
Speaking of Johnny Depp, but Sweeney Todd is a fucking banger.
It actually is.
It's a banger. I need to revisit that. I haven't seen it in a while.
I haven't seen it. My favorite anecdote about Sweeney Todd is that when it came out, it got an 18 because it's very, very violent. But there was this these three teenage girls who wrote to the BBFC with some sort of petition asking it to be lowered to a 12 so that they could see it.
A 12?
Oh my god!
Directly to the BBFC.
Wow!
Take it to the top.
That is some dedication, indeed.
You'd have to cut out a third of the movie.
Yeah, I don't even think.
Yeah,
it'd just be like 3 minutes long.
Yeah.
So let's segue now onto rumours and news in film. So Tanj, what are our top headlines of the week?
Basically everything's getting delayed because of the coronavirus. That's to put it simply, Indiana Jones got delayed. Candyman's been delayed. Like 8 other different films have been delayed.
I think most of them actually have dates now. I think Mulan has been redated now to, I think, the end of July.
Yeah. And then a lot of films that were like scheduled for like an April release have just been released digitally. Like
the New Mutants. It was finally going to release.
Oh my god, right? I was like, here we go, boys. The film like no one's allowed to see, and now it's like been cancelled. Like God doesn't want the New Mutants to be seen. It's a fact.
Not even.
So we got Candyman delayed, Rick and Morty writers join Ant-Man 3.
Oh, you mean this guy Scott Lang, right? He turned himself into a pickle, funniest shit I've ever seen.
Yeah.
Oh, he did it.
And then, we're not going to see any more Harrison Ford until 2022, if he's still around.
Why is he in that movie?
Yeah, I was going to say, if he makes...
Louis, that's so horrible to say!
What? Here's the thing. By the time Indiana Jones 2 will come out, Harrison Ford will be 81 years old.
Yes, true. Sorry about that. Just being realistic. Oh my gosh. Just reading through the headlines now, it's pretty awful. Oh, let's not look at ads.
Oh,
what else have we got?
Let's see if I can find the IndieWire article. Edgar Wright. Oh, yes, am I jumping?
No, go. I think anyone, jump in.
Okay.
So, fill the airtime.
It's pretty much long and short of it. Edgar Wright is now set to adapt the sci-fi comedy, possibly musical, story book about an android who like has an emotional awakening called Set My Heart to 5, and I don't know when that's being scheduled for, but it's going to be good fun.
Oh my god, that sounds amazing! Is that right off the bat of Last Night at Soho? Last Night in Soho.
Yeah,
cool.
There's a musical.
Possibly, I'm looking up.
He would do the best musicals ever.
Sounds like an improvement on like Rocky Horror Film Show or something like that, kind of sci-fi musical kind of, you know, fancy stuff.
Very Little Shop of Horrors.
Oh, I love Little Shop so...
Wait, are they doing another one?
We were just talking about like horror musical type things. So yeah, according to the synopsis, the story is set in an all-too-human 2054 and follows Jared, an android that works as a dentist, there we go, Little Sharp reference, as he undergoes an emotional awakening that is sparked by an introduction to 80s and 90s movies.
Ooh.
That sounds pretty great.
I do quite like the sound of that.
I wonder
how well all these futuristic movies are going to age. Like, can you believe Blade Runner's already happened?
I know.
Yeah, that was last year, November, wasn't it?
I've seen those timelines of like when films are going to be, and like it's been Blade Runner.
And it's so weird how, like in Blade Runner, Rutger Hauer's character died in 2019. In real life, Rutger Hauer died in 2019.
Yeah, I didn't even think of it that way. Wow.
pod.
It's insane.
Come to think of it, that is insane.
I'm just blowing minds here today.
Yeah. Blowing minds, tossing shade, you know.
The only person I've shaded here is myself. Let's be
yeah,
real.
True. You are self-shaming today. It's fine.
I'm just quickly dropping. My friend has just sent me a message because she's listening. Hi, Emily. Has just sent me a link to an article saying that they're remaking Little Shop of Horrors with Chris Evans.
Chris Hemsworth?
Chris Evans, the Captain America one.
Oh, right.
As whom?
Let's have a look. I assume he's playing the main character. I hope he's the dentist.
I don't.
He's playing the dentist in the remake.
Oh my gosh. I would doubt that, but I rewatched Knives Out over the weekend, and yeah.
Did you like it?
I'd already seen it, but like, it's even better like watching it the second time around. You just sort of pick up on everything. And also, I watched it with my parents, who are massive fans of whodunits. So it was really entertaining to just watch them theorizing out loud as the movie was going on and just being so horrifically wrong about everything.
Ryan Johnson.
Favorite time to watch films is when I've like introduced a film I've already seen, like a psychological film, to someone else, and they're like, "Oh my god, he's gonna do that!" I'm like, "You have no idea." I watched Focus, the Will Smith Margot Robbie one, and also like 10 Cloverfield Lane as well.
I watched Trance, directed by Danny Boyle. Yeah. I saw that in the cinema with my dad, and we were just both equally confused.
Trance
isn't the best of films, I have to say. I mean, we've already had a chat about that, haven't we, Sam Midwood?
Let's not.
It was also very awkward in a movie where there are several scenes of full frontal nudity, watching that with your dad right next to you when you're 14.
it definitely would scar you for life, I imagine. For sure.
That got 2,500 views on Twitter, so you know, I think you might be in the minority.
I think I'm in the minority. Minority can't speak today. Minority. Minority Report. That's also not a very good film.
Oh, I like it. There's some cool stuff. He chases his eyeballs, man.
Oh, okay, all right. Yeah, that bit's all right.
I
need to back up my own opinions. I keep just saying this is bad, this is good, this is bad, this is good. I'm just that person, that you know.
But I'm just curious why you think Minority Report is a great sci-fi action film. Decent.
Alright, yeah. Maybe it's just because I'm not really into action films so much, I think. But if you see it through the lens of it being sci-fi action, it does well. It does well. Fine. I concede.
Wow! Trance is 4,100.
What? So Trance has been performing really well on our social media then?
On Twitter, yeah.
Wow.
Nice.
One of my friends who's listening along says, I agree with whoever said Minority Report was bad.
Yes!
She says she hates it because she hates Tom Cruise.
Oh, okay. Do you know what? That's a complete valid reason.
He's weird.
He's a Scientologist.
The Scientology... Like, the only person I'll let slide with this whole Scientology thing is Elizabeth Moss, because I think she was raised on it. Right. And like, when she gets asked about it in interviews and everything, you can tell like she's uncomfortable talking about it. John Travolta's a bit of a yikes as well, especially Battlefield Earth. Very strong yikes.
Young John Travolta, like Carrie, Saturday Night Fever. A little bit older John Travolta in I can't even think. Pulp Fiction and
Face Off.
Isn't Face Off with Nick Cage in it as well?
Yeah.
Oh my god, that's like my favourite Nick Cage film.
Okay, wait. But John Travolta's best role is in Hairspray, and you cannot change my mind.
No, I think Grease. Grease is the word.
But does Grease have John Travolta in drag?
No.
I rest my case.
I often get confused between John Travolta and Val Kilmer. I get confused by both of them. I don't know. They're just both these kind of like sort of big, hunky, strange looking men who are like kind of sort of like, take the character of like, I'm gonna say something that's really important, but it's not actually that important. It's, I don't know.
With Dolph Lundgren and Val Kilmer.
Really though, so should be okay.
Yeah. By the way, for anyone else who's just tuning into the stream as well, you can also chat live on the Spreaker chat function. So for anyone who's tuning in and wants to like comment and see comments live, you can go to the live episode page where you can comment underneath in live chat. Woo! And also, how can people get involved in the show? Dan, anyone? Tanj, anyone?
So basically, we've sent out a form, application form, that you can fill out your details, fill out your Skype name, what you do, and then you'll be considered to be on the show as a guest. You can talk about your profession, you can talk about what you do related to film, and basically just present yourself and you'll come on, you'll talk about you and what you do, and we'll talk about films that you like, and it'll be a good time.
And there's a very happy smiley picture of Dan there in the studio with Tanj on the form, which is sweet. I love that.
It's
cool.
Like super wide and panoramic. It's the best.
Woo! So yeah, cool, awesome. What else? Should we have a look at some trailers? Should we talk about trailers and stuff? Yeah. So what's our first trailer of the week? Someone, anyone?
So this first movie is the one I wanted to talk about. It's Never Really, Rarely, Sometimes, Always. It's about a teenage woman who decides to, she decides to have an abortion. And it's like, it is incredibly sad, to put it like, I think it's a very interesting story that I think a lot of people would like. And if you liked, did you ever watch the movie Paper Towns?
Yes, I did.
Yeah. If you like that movie, I think you'll like this one as well, definitely.
Nice. Cool. Thank you. Let's take a look at it.
It's called Never, Rarely, Sometimes, Always.
Okay.
Okay, and here it is.
Watch the trailer.
I didn't see you at school today.
I went to the doctor.
What's wrong?
Girl problems.
I'm just gonna go to the toilet.
Don't you ever just wish you were a dude?
Oh yeah, that's good.
I can't hear it.
This is the most magical sound you will ever hear.
Okay. That's cool.
You can tell from these shots. I'm sorry.
I'm just not ready to be alone.
Lots of sad faces.
I mean, you can already tell from the fact that this movie about abortion is sad.
Oh yeah.
Have you
to
try another place?
Lots of close-ups to, like, worried expressions.
You should just be a movie narrator.
What are you doing?
I know. It's like, have you ever seen the Who Killed Captain Alex? Nollywood action film.
My cousin.
You wouldn't steal it. You wouldn't kill a police officer.
I know you can't
steal his helmet. And go to the toilet.
I'll figure it out.
And then give it to his grieving widow. And then steal it again.
Yeah. I'm gonna have to rewatch the IT Crowd because of that like, reminder sure that it exists. Safe. I'm just gonna watch it for, like fifth time. Yeah.
I know this is hard. I'm gonna ask you some questions. It can be really personal. Just answer either never, rarely, sometimes, or always.
Hello. What do we think of that? I mean, of course, it's a bit different for us because obviously we can't hear it. But just judging by the look of it. Oh, let's not play another trailer. not yet, anyway. Yeah, any comments on that, if people can?
I think I really like that it seems to be focused a lot on, I mean, as a sociologist, the kind of concept of sistership is kind of wonky to me. But it does seem to focus on, like, the relationships between women in these kinds of situations. Like, a lot of the time these films are... Sorry to everyone who's a man, but the film is very much like, this is the impact you're having on the men. It's never like, like, you know, this is the impact it's had on you. It seems to reflect it quite nicely.
Yeah.
I mean, this movie just needs to exist, and I already know it's going to be a better abortion movie than this. There was this train wreck last year that came out called Unplanned, which is basically, like, for those listening who haven't heard of it, it's...
It's about this. I can't remember her name, but she. It was. It's a, based on a true story. This lady who works at a Planned Parenthood and then sort of like saw an abortion or something. I don't know. And it's like, hang on, I'm going to become an anti-abortion activist. And it's made by, you know, crazy Southern American Christians who claimed conservative bias when the movie was rated R, despite the fact that there's a very bloody scene of an abortion in it.
What did I just walk into?
It's chaos.
A bloody abortion scene.
Yeah.
Explain, Tom. Please explain.
I've just explained it. What the hell?
Just for Dan, who's just come in.
Long story short, I'm comparing this to an anti-abortion conservative movie that came out in the States last year called Unplanned.
Right.
And disclaimer, I haven't seen it, but I've heard it is terrible.
It is terrible.
So, what is this film? Is this film pro-life, pro-choice, or does it kind of veer between the two?
I can't really tell from the trailer.
It doesn't really take a stance on like the pro-life, pro-choice kind of thing. It's more about the characters and why they would make that choice instead of is it a good choice for them to make?
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Cool.
Very cool. Should we look at our next trailer?
Yeah.
So our next trailer, tell us about that. So it's Nebraska.
Nebraska, that was, who was that, Sam, I think?
Yeah. So I watched this film last night. So it came out in 2014. Got nominated for Best Picture at the Oscars. And I think it had six Oscar nominations. So it's basically about this old man who thinks he's won the $1 million, and he's determined to get to Nebraska, and it's and he ends up going back to his hometown and reliving his childhood memories and family interactions. So it's a really good film, so see what you think. And it's quite funny as well.
So let's check it out.
Have a look.
Hit it rich, and I don't see any of it. That would be wrong.
Are you threatening my family?
Everybody's saying how Woody Grant's a millionaire.
That's no big deal.
No big deal? Jeez. Million here, million there. Well, the newspaper's gonna do a big write-up on you.
Honestly, right? Woody didn't win anything.
You're a damn liar.
Hey.
Come on. Have a beer with your old man. He's somebody.
Oh, let's pick
Hello.
This one up.
Hello. That looks cool. Very cool. Obviously, it's an older film. 2013, it came out. Nebraska.
Yeah, 2013.
Any thoughts? Yeah.
The way you said older film made it sound like from like the '30s.
Well, it's got a lovely black and white style that's quite reminiscent of 60s.
Black and white, it must be old.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've got to put on my old man voice. Back in the day, 2013.
it's black and white film, it must be old. And now I'm thinking of The Lighthouse.
Which is a great
I was thinking of Francis Ha, that's a 1929 film. Yeah, just old black and white.
I love France. I love Neil Baumbach.
it also has the guy who plays Better Call Saul, Bob Odenkirk.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's just a really like happy film and heartwarming film towards the end, and you know, it's the old guy, he's in his like 80s, and then his wife is like, you know, this typical like, you don't know what you're doing and you're out of your mind and all that. So yeah, yeah, my best Nebraskan accent, but yeah,
it was so, a good attempt. Sam. Yeah,
it's we couldn't, it's you might have to source it from unknown sources, but it's a good film. So
what unknown sources are we talking about? It's
very strange.
Well, let's just say Mr. Netflix, I don't think has it. So
I'm not sure that
there
Monsieur
are online
Netflix.
Legal movie rentals that you can get it from, because we here at Smoke Film Show run a very, very legal process.
Imagine paying money to rent movies.
I'm not saying it's right or wrong, but there's ways to watch it.
You're presenting a choice. You're not pro-life. You're not pro-choice. You know, you're somewhere in the middle.
Oh dear! Yeah. Oh dear! We're doing that.
I am Switzerland.
What a poor comparison to use, really.
Extremely.
Yeah, I know. All the more reason to use it.
Yeah, but Payne is an interesting director, isn't he? Because
he's done that Clooney movie, hasn't he?
Downsizing.
Yeah. Sorry? He's done that Clooney movie, really? No, The Descendants. No, was that with George Clooney? I swear it was.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a really beautiful film. Very charming.
Happiness as well. No, is it? No, not Happiness. He did Election, wasn't it?
I think so.
Did he?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh,
the one
yeah.
that. Yeah.
Oh, because he's Sideways. That,
yeah, and About Schmidt that I've seen, which is very odd, but it's good.
Okay, but Nebraska. I'm really. Nebraska's not free on Prime. I was just looking it up. But one that is, that I'm just going to shout out, no relation, Inside Llewyn Davis. Just watch it.
Oh, yeah.
Is it on there?
It is.
Fantastic.
Right.
Oh, get on that. But yeah, had such a crazy career, hasn't he? I mean, just like we've got it up on the share screen, like all the films he's done. He did Jurassic Park 3! Sorry, what?
He didn't direct it.
Okay. I was going to say that would have been a very much weirder film.
Yeah. Inside Out 3, what?
That's from 1992.
Inside Out 3, back in time. When Riley is old and...
Oh. They even released it in 92, like preparing for like the time travel.
Oh, brilliant.
But yeah.
Brilliant.
There you go.
Should we take a look at our next trailer, which is Onward. Anyone want to talk about Onward?
It's a Disney film that's out on digital. Disney Plus, isn't it?
Yeah, I think so.
It came out like early, I think, May?
March.
No.
It came out in March in the cinema, and it, you know,
pre-lockdown.
This whole thing happened.
Mm. Yeah, no one wanted to see it because they wanted to live.
Yeah, they couldn't go onward. They had to be inward and in their houses.
Shut the fuck up.
Stay at home. Save for the NHS. Save lives.
Retire. Retire.
Right. So without further ado, we're going to watch Onward now.
And on that bombshell.
This is gonna turn into a D&D segment, and I know it. Like, it's just gonna end up Dungeons and Dragons, but that's what we're here for.
By the laws of yore, I must dub thee a man today.
Oh, yeah.
Kneel before me.
That's okay.
I have a gift from your dad. He just said to give you this when you were both over 16.
No way! It's a wizard staff. Dad was a wizard.
What? Your dad was an accountant.
This spell brings him back. For one whole day, Dad will be back.
What?
Back? Like back to life? That's not possible.
It is with this.
I'm gonna meet Dad.
I definitely remember Dad having a top part.
Oh, what did I do? Hi.
We only have 24 hours to bring the rest of him back.
Until then, ta-da!
Oh, that's great, Dad. You look just like I remember.
shape.
If it's adventure you seek, you've come to the right tavern.
Oh, no.
We might be out of gas.
But it says we have a full tank.
No, that doesn't work. Growth spell. We grow the can, and then the gas inside will grow with it. Oh! Elbows up.
I'm trying to focus here. And you're... Oh, no.
Cool. That looks really good.
It
that
does.
That looks so good.
It does look quite cute.
Very, very cute, indeed. I love that bit at the end. Yeah. So, what do people think about Onwards and what Pixar and Disney Plus are doing at the moment?
Wait, is it on Disney Plus?
I think it's on Disney Plus. Is it, or is it going to be? I don't know.
I think it's going to be.
It might be because there's a bit of a correlation between US Disney Plus and UK Disney Plus, because I know Frozen 2 is already on UK and US Disney Plus, but in the UK it's not going to be on until I think July.
Yeah,
the rest of the season of The Mandalorian.
Oh yeah. My god, The Mandalorian's so good.
Oh, I love The Mandalorian so much.
Fully expecting not to like it, and I was like, after Rise of Skywalker, I'm like, this is it, boys. My stormtrooper armor, it's over. But I absolutely adore The Mandalorian.
Yeah, I'm so glad I finally get the Baby Yoda references now. Like, obviously, where has Baby Yoda come from? Is it just someone came up with this, like, just fancy de-aging Yoda, and now I'm like, oh, right, that's.
Baby Yoda is so cute, though. Oh my god! Like,
I love
it was annoying that after Baby Yoda, everybody like just started doing. Everybody just started babyfying their own characters, and it was just weird.
Yeah.
The only one I'll allow was Baby Sonic, because that was planned like when the movie
Way
was first.
Yeah. Well, I need to watch.
And also Baby Sonic was adorable.
Sonic film.
You should.
So we got our next trailer.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, you're good. Right,
so we've got our next trailer, which is The Lovebirds, which is coming out soon. Lots of PDA on the first frame of that trailer, but we love it. So tell us about Lovebirds, anyone?
So I put this up there because I thought there would be sound.
There is no sound. There is
not seen the trailer.
There is. Let there be light. Let there be sound. There is sound for the audience.
And the audience are the main thing.
Just put the Spreaker stream on at the same time.
You can put the Spreaker one on. There'll be a little bit of a delay, but you can put it on alongside, and it will work.
That's not. When there's sound, you will hear that this trailer is very hilarious. this is a really good comedy.
I'm laughing already.
Very good. So, Dan's laughing already. Let's give it a go.
Looks like love is finally found me. I love you.
Shit!
Police officer!
He's a criminal!
We know he's dead, but we didn't kill him.
He like tripped for a murder or whatever.
We didn't murder anybody.
1, 2, 3, go.
No. Jabron!
Okay, the guy's name is Jabron.
Run, Leilani.
And the girl's name's actually Leilani. She's running too now. Kind of slowly, she's wearing heels that look actually amazing.
We have to go to the police because we have nothing to hide.
Why did you run from the scene of the crime?
Good question, officer.
That's me covering up my body cam so I can beat your ass.
We're so fucked.
We just need to find the guy the police are looking for.
Do you suggest we actually go out there and solve a
murder?
It's locked. Did you think it was one of those men-only doors? All we need is a name, and then we're in the clear.
Hey, man, it's been a minute.
Who the fuck are you?
Who do you work for? You little bitch. You little beanbag ballless bitch.
Yeah.
You think about your grandma and that furry beanbag bitch.
What?
These people are super dangerous, and they're really powerful.
Stop!
This is some Handmaid's Tale bullshit.
We have imposters.
Oh no, imposters. That sucks.
Everyone unmask yourself.
Oh shit. Nobody else took their masks off.
I'm gonna give you lovebirds a choice. What's behind this door or bacon grease to the face?
I don't want grease on my face.
Is it gonna shit on me?
Oh, take the grease.
Free up my love.
Brother.
Okay, that happened.
Did he just get killed by a horse?
I think so. No, he didn't get killed by it. I think he just got, you know,
hoofed.
He just got kicked in the head.
Yeah. It was killed in Red Dead 2, that's for sure.
I mean, it looks like the director's stepbrothers directed Eyes Wide Shut.
And it also looks like it's very referential, because it also references, like, you know, in has anyone not seen John Wick Chapter 3? Where, like, there's that, like just incessant, like, horse-kicking scene where, like, people who are, like, enemies who are fighting him get kicked with horses. Yeah. Anyway, it's a very interesting kind of film. Any other comments about the lovebirds that we watched in silence?
I love.
Did we?
I love like Kumail Nanjiani's writing. So it's like good to see him in comedy because he has very good timing.
Yeah.
And that. I also love Issa Rae. So like it's like perfect.
I don't know who these people are. I need to check it out.
Hashtag no. Louis Holder is cancelled. Let's get it straight.
Have we explained the context yet?
No, don't. It'll be better.
There would be better if it's no context, but also if everyone here like tweets like 10 different tweets right now on their Twitter pages, it will definitely become a trending thing at the moment.
Let's get it going.
It only needs like 100 hits to be trending, guys. Come on. I'm even advocating for it, and I'm the one that's being cancelled. So,
you can cancel me next.
It'll be great.
It's all right. We can do a round robin of cancellations.
Any exposure's good exposure, right, Louis?
You've been fired and cancelled.
And no such thing as bad press, guys. This is true.
Hell yeah.
So we go on now to our final trailer of the week before we try and attempt to do. I don't know if we even attempt to do the soundtrack of the week because it might not work in the current format. But Trolls World Tour, to tell us about that, it's Jayne Flowers. Hello.
Hello. So I chose Trolls World Tour one because it's a squeakquel, so always like a squeakquel.
I've forgotten that movie existed.
Just in case you forgot about Alvin and the Chipmunks. This film is really interesting for who they cast. I'll go into that a little bit later. But I think the concept is nice. It's cute. It's feel good. I think it's kind of come at a good time to be just something you can kind of, especially for kids, but also for adults, you can just kind of watch and be like, that was nice, and come out the other end. So yeah.
Cool. Let's take a look.
Once upon a time, there were two trolls. They saved the world. Pretty cute.
Oh my god. There's no captions. Sorry, guys.
And love, Tiny and Daddy Al.
There's a world full of other trolls. How different can they be?
I'm gonna unite the six strings. By the end of my world tour, I'm gonna turn all the trolls into rock zombies.
Rock and roll!
I will overpower them with glitter.
She wants to destroy us.
We need to unite the troll to save all music. Let's sing them the most important songs in the history of music.
This ought to be good.
Yo, I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want.
So who let the dogs out? You suck!
I knew it. Who let the dogs out? Too far.
Good selection.
Who's ready to roar?
Prepare for battle.
Let's go save the world!
Can't stop it.
Can stop the feeling.
How are we gonna hug our way out of this one?
I will protect you no matter what. Pinky promise.
You can't go back on a pinky promise. A pinky promise. Dang.
A smooth jazz troll? Being paralyzed by
I can't feel my face.
Well, that happened. So tell us, guys, what do we think about Trolls World Tour from our silent preview there? We're all speechless, clearly.
Yeah. Very trippy. Very fucking
it's
trippy.
Just so much colour and so much energy.
There's a lot going
like
on.
The animation with Trolls.
Yeah. I mean, yeah.
It's alright.
It's alright.
There's okay. Everything's like, you know, it's like having a spoonful of sugar and then another one. Like, this is to it.
It's like it's having a spoonful of multicoloured sugar of, like, the sort of fizzy popping, like, candy and stuff. That is just, like, an explosion.
Jelly beans. Yeah. Like, the Marvelous Creation bars. Yeah.
Dare I mention that Omar was saying this was a kind of shared hallucination. Is that right?
Yes.
That we were experiencing while watching it. Yeah. Due to the flurry of colours.
I will say about this film that, there's a couple people in this film that basically wrote to Pixar and were like, you are going to let us in your film. And Pixar were like, never. And then now they are in the film. they're like minor roles, but if you look at kind of like Pixar, this film relies on Pixar. YouTubers. Pardon? Sorry, DreamWorks. That's going to be like everyone on the forums, like, how could you confuse these people? DreamWorks.
At least it's not as egregious as Louis.
What's that? I missed that.
Don't worry.
You can tell me after the show.
Hashtag cancelled.
Hashtag cancelled.
Cancelled. I'm getting cancelled now.
So, are there any other parting thoughts or comments at all?
Not that I can think of.
I like the little tiny silver guy. I don't know what that's about. I haven't seen these films, but I like his little dance. It's cute. Yeah.
Oh, he's got a really his voice actor. I'm like obsessed.
I think what we can learn from this podcast is don't do illegal streaming and don't be racist.
That's not exactly. That's exactly it.
I don't think we need to learn the latter. I think we already kind of know that.
Yeah.
Unless otherwise some people have serious problems.
Definitely.
You feel entirely anointed because I remind you not to be racist.
Oh, no, I think it was just a shared reminder, wasn't it? Wasn't it, Dan?
Yeah.
Cancelled Louis Holder.
Yes.
We got him.
Hopefully the lack of audio fidelity over the internet stream will mute what you were saying, Omar. But hey, We can hope. Thanks, guys. That was wicked.
Yeah.
That was cool. How can people find out about the show, Sam?
Oh, wow. Funny. Good question, Louis. So we obviously have all our... We are on social media. We have our Instagram account, @smoke radio film show. Oh, I should probably know that. That's really embarrassing. hang on.
Run it.
@ smoke film show.
There we go.
On Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook.
On Twitter, on Facebook page as well, on our Facebook page. But you can listen to this on demand, on Spotify, on Apple Music, iTunes Store, and on... Cloud on what's the last one? You set me up, Louis. This is not
this is good. This is good practice, you know.
Google Podcasts, isn't it?
Mixed Cloud as well is the one that they got. Yeah, there we go.
And
I don't even know what Mixed Cloud is, so I'm okay with forgetting that one.
Yeah, I think just focus on Spotify and Apple. That's what people are using, really.
Yeah. Not alienate our Deezer users, guys. Come on.
No, it's true.
I agree.
What about the guys on Zoom?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, thank you very much to everyone. Let's try and do a round robin. Let's attempt to do this. I mean, it never quite works, but oh well.
What about, let's do it alphabetically.
Oh, okay. Interesting. Oh. I need to remember the alphabet all of a sudden.
This stressful very quickly.
How so everyone look at the names and just go accordingly.
Try and remember the alphabet, guys.
The alphabet? I don't know that Pokemon.
I can barely find where maybe, people are listed.
Maybe it's
where am I supposed to be looking?
You click on the names. If you click on the names at the top.
Oh, all right.
I'm not even entirely sure what we're doing.
I think we're saying goodbye, but it's taken an awful long time to say goodbye.
Can we just say bye on our own accord?
I think someone just
that
chime
sounds
in.
Cute.
Yeah. All right. Should we try it?
Like Teletubbies.
Okay. 3, 2, 1,
bye!
That was cute. I like that.
Thank really you so much for tuning in, and see you next week.
Absolutely, next week. Yes.
Cool.